One great thing about Android is all the different shortcuts that you can use. In this video, I wanted to share some of my favorites and how I have my phone set up for accessibility features and just opening apps in general. And if you have shortcuts that you use, share them in the comments and share it with the community so we can all try them. This is Carrie on Accessibility, and welcome to Quick Accessibility Tips. It's been a while since I've come out with an episode, and I hope you like this one. Let's go over how I have my Android accessibility shortcuts set up. I go in depth with a lot of these shortcuts in other videos, and I will link them up in the cards and in the description if you want to learn more about them. First, I have the volume key shortcut, so that's when you press and hold the volume up and down together for a couple seconds.
TalkBack on.
That turns on TalkBack, and then doing it again will turn TalkBack off.
TalkBack off.
Next, I have triple tap magnification, so I can triple tap on the screen. And now I can move around and see everything zoomed in. Next, I also use the accessibility gesture. So if I swipe up with two fingers from the bottom, it'll be three fingers if you're using TalkBack. That toggles screen inversion. Unfortunately, screen inversion doesn't show up when you're screen recording on a Pixel. We're not gonna talk about the problems with screen inversion though. The cool thing about the accessibility gesture is if I swipe up with two fingers and hold, then release, now I can toggle to a different accessibility feature, like select to speak. Now if I do the quick swipe again with two fingers, I have the select to speak enabled and I can have it read to me.
YouTube, weather, asana, calendar, Play Store, photos.
And if I do it again, it's still on select to speak. But if I want to switch back to toggle color inversion on and off, I just do that again, swipe up and hold with two fingers, then release, then I tap on color inversion. And now, anytime I swipe up with two fingers, it will invert colors. Next, I have some tiles in my quick settings. And namely, I have flashlight, which is very useful. I also have that on my lock screen too. I consider flashlight an accessibility need that I have, you know, sometimes just need some light. Then I also have font size, which is the bottom right on my phone. I like the Pixel quick settings because they're really big buttons. And even though the text is cut off, I just kind of remember where the button is and then I just go by memory. So I have font size here, and I can quickly change the font size if I need to. If I go back there, you can tap and hold that button, and it'll take you directly to display size and text, and then you can change things like high contrast text, bold text, and display size right from here. You can add other tiles to the quick settings like live captions and a magnifier, color inversion, dark theme, even the recorder app, and quick add a task on Asana, though that's not necessarily an accessibility setting. There's quite a few different things that you could add that could possibly help with accessibility, so that would be something that you could check out. Next, I have an app called Button Mapper, which I just absolutely love. I have it set so that if I press and hold my volume up key,
short text,
it opens Seeing AI. Then if I press and hold the volume down key, it opens WeZoom, which is my magnifier of choice. The screen recording forced WeZoom to look like it's in portrait, but it's actually in landscape. I also switched over to Nova Launcher. A shout out to John from Blind Android Users for recommending Nova Launcher. I tried it a long time ago, but I retried it again just a few weeks ago, and I really, really like it. There's a lot of customization you can do, but maybe I'll make a separate video on that. But one thing that you can do is add gesture shortcuts. So some of them work with TalkBack and some of them don't. The pinch in does work with TalkBack, so I'll turn TalkBack on really quick.
TalkBack on.
And now if I pinch in.
Lookout text mode, select mode.
I have Google Lookout open. Then I'll go back home.
One of two.
Now if I pinch outward, it will open Amazon Alexa. Oops, sorry. Quick note here, the Nova Launcher gestures only work when you're on the home screen. There's a rotate two fingers to the left and rotate to the right, kind of like the iOS rotor. So if I rotate it to the right, it opens Bing.
Wallpapers.
I like that because then I can talk to Copilot.
Home screen 1 of 2.
And then if I rotate with two fingers to the left,
Audible.
It opens Audible. Another thing that I have is the back tap or quick tap, which is what Pixel calls it. That is set to be my eyes and automatically goes to be my AI. So if I do a
be my eyes, please wait 3 period.
Double tap there on the back of the phone. All right, and I have be my AI open. And there you go, that's how I have my phone set up and all the different shortcuts that I use. When I do use a Samsung phone, I love the fact that there's a volume up and side key shortcut. I kind of miss that whenever I'm on a Pixel. But if you have shortcuts that you use, share it in the comments. I would love to know, and I think the community would love to know. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up below. And if you want to support my work and what I do here, consider becoming a Patreon or YouTube channel member. Thanks so much, and I will catch you in the next video.